Hey everyone, welcome to Homeschool, and we are with the chapter Diversity in Living Organisms. Under that, we started with Animal Kingdom, yes or no? The Kingdom Animalia, where we finished discussions about the two important phyla, that is the phylum Porifera and phylum Coelenterata. And now we will discuss about the third important phylum, that is Platyhelminthes, phylum Platyhelminthes. You know, the word platy, you can see the word platy in the sense flat. And the organisms that come under this phylum are commonly called as flatworms. They are called flatworms because they are flat. Right? Say for example, planaria. First, let me draw a structure of planaria. You know, this is how planaria looks like. Okay, so this is what we call planaria. See, it is very much flat. So, all organisms that come under Platyhelminthes are flat. That's the reason they are called as flatworms. Right? And they are worm-like. Helminthus means worm. The meaning of the word helminthus is nothing but worm-like. Flat, worm-like. So they are called flatworms. And now, let us try to list out the main characteristics of this particular phylum. First point that you have to remember is, you know, body is bilaterally symmetric. Body is bilaterally symmetric. So these meanings are very important to understand. What do you mean by the bilaterally symmetric? Bilaterally symmetrical. You know, it means that if you cut an organism in one particular direction, you will get two equal halves. Say for example, if I cut this particular organism in this direction, vertically, okay, in a straight line, in a central part, you get two equal halves, no? Left side of the body is similar to the right side of the body. The body design in the left side is similar to the body design of the right side. This is what we call bilaterally symmetric, okay? So, what do you mean by bilaterally symmetric? If an organism cut longitudinally, when it is cut longitudinally, we get two equal halves. We get two equal halves. That means left and right side of the body is same. Okay, this is what the meaning of the word bilaterally symmetrical. So even we humans are bilaterally symmetrical. Imagine if this part has been centrally, if you cut an organism in the middle exactly in a vertical direction, okay, in the longitudinal direction, do we have two equal halves? Definitely. So imagine if you cut my face like this. Say left side of my face is similar to the right side. Left side I have one eye, you know, half a nose I get, half a mouth I get, you know, my chin in the left side is exactly similar to the right side. Right? So this is what we call bilaterally symmetrical. Okay? So it's very important to understand the meaning of these words, guys. Clear? So this is a very important feature of Platyhelminthes, right? And the second one is they are triploblastic. What do you mean by the word triploblastic? Have three germ layers. So about the germ layers, we discussed in the previous class. Isn't it? So whenever a male gamete combines with a female gamete during reproduction, you get a new life with a single cell, that is called zygote. zygote divides to form embryo. And now embryo differentiates. Embryo divides into three germ layers. What are the three germ layers, guys? Ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. Isn't it? So what do you mean by ectoderm? This layer of cells are responsible for forming skeleton of a body. And this layer of cells are responsible for forming different organs. Organs, eyes is one organ, mouth is one organ, heart is one organ, liver is one organ, right? So these are organs. So how are these organs are formed? By the cells of mesoderms. Okay, and endoderm, this layer of cells is responsible for forming lining of organs, right? So all this we have discussed in the previous class. So here in the platyhelminthes phylum, the organisms shows triploblastic condition. That means the embryo divides into three germ layers. Okay, so that means here in this phylum, you will observe organ level organization. Okay, what do you mean by organ level organization? Organs are get to formed. Okay, organs formation can takes place. Okay, say you have a proof here. You can see the planaria. You know, I have put two dots in the head region, right? So these two are actually eyes, guys. Okay, so very primitive type of eyes, eye spots. Eye is an organ. So you have observed the formation of organs. Whereas in the coelenterata, you don't have any organs. In porifera, you don't have any organs, right? So here, organ level formation, organ formation can take place, are observed. That's what we call organ level organization. Okay, that means in this particular phylum, in these particular organisms, you know, you will get to see the formation of organs. Clear? Not the true organs, but organ-like things you will observe in these organisms. Fine. And the next and very important point is, these organisms are dorsiventrally flat. Okay, this is a very, very important word, dorsiventrally flat. What do you mean by dorsiventrally flat? Dorsiventrally means top to bottom. So they are flat from top to bottom portion of a body. Okay, so they are flat organisms. From top to bottom, they are flat. So that is what we call dorsiventrally flat. Clear? Fine. And you know, they are free living or parasitic. Parasitic. Okay. They can live freely in a water or a soil, or they can be parasitic. What do you mean by the word parasitic? Living in other organism. Living in other organism for food. Okay, so they live in another living organism to take food for their survival. So that's what we call parasitic. Okay, see, sometimes in our head we observe lice. Isn't it? So lice will be there. So lice are called parasites because lice are living in another living organism. Humans are another living organism. So why you find lice in the head? Lice are present in the head because for the food, because for their survival, right? So such an organisms are called parasites. So when one organism lives in another living organisms for survival, for the food purpose, is called parasites. Clear? So these are the main important points you have to remember. The three points are very important here. One is the body is bilaterally symmetrical and triploblastic. That means you have the three germ layers, and the organ level organization starts from here. That means organ formation takes place from this phylum onwards. Okay, in every phylum you will observe the true organ formation slowly, right? And another important point is these organisms are dorsiventrally flat from top to bottom. They are flat in nature, right? So now let us watch a beautiful visual on Platyhelminthes. Visual
on the phylum Platyhelminthes, famously called as the flatworms. See, this is a beautiful example of flatworm. You can see how flat it is. Dorsiventrally flat, that means from top to bottom of a body the organism is flat. That is what we mean by dorsiventrally flat. This is another example for Platyhelminthes. And body is bilaterally symmetric, I told. So if you cut a body exactly at the center from top to bottom, you can see two equal halves, yes or no? And that means the left side of the body design is exactly similar to the right side of the body design. It's not that left side is different from right side, right? So when you cut a organism from top to bottom longitudinally, you get two equal halves. That is what we mean by bilaterally symmetric. That means left side is almost similar to the right side. Okay, this is a very, very important point. And one more thing is, in case of Platyhelminthes, the formation of head region starts actually. You will have a distinct head, right? See, in this organism, this is the head part. I mean, you actually find a small eye spots. You know, the head region gets separated from a body. That is what we call it as cephalization. So, formation of a head region starts from this phylum onwards. Clear? So, most of them are marine. Okay? And these are some examples of Platyhelminthes. You can see different species. This is one type of a flatworm, and all these are different varieties of flatworms we have in our nature. That's all about a phylum Platyhelminthes.
Now coming to the fourth phylum, that is phylum Nematoda. And the phylum Nematoda is also called with the name Askhelminthes. Askhelminthes. You know, what do you mean by the word ask? Asky means worm. You know, the meaning of the word nematoda, N-E-M-A, means thread. Okay, so they are actually thread-like worms, round worms. Have you heard of round worms? Have you ever heard the worms in a stomach or intestine? Especially in the smaller children, we keep hearing that, you know, they have worms in a stomach or worms in an intestine. So, you know, vermicide tablets or syrups will be given for them. Isn't it? Doctor will say whenever you take a child to a doctor and say that the child is having a stomach pain. So what is the first type of a medicine that a doctor will give you? Vermicide, the medicine that can kill the worms. Doctor would say, oh, maybe there are certain worms in his intestine or a stomach. That's the reason he is having a pain or he is having a digestion problem or whatever, right? So this is a quite common problem in the children, especially younger children, children of 1, 2, 3 and 4 years age children. Right? So sometimes what happens, they have the round worms in their intestine or stomach. So that spoils their digestion process. That's the reason they get stomachache. So these round worms belong to this particular phylum, guys. If you want to see how they look like, you wait for the visual that I show at the end. Clear? See, all the round worm category comes under the phylum Nematoda. Clear? enough, let us study about the characteristics of the organisms that come under a phylum Nematoda. First and foremost, okay, body is bilaterally symmetric. So here also, body is bilaterally symmetrical. So what do you mean by bilaterally symmetrical? If you cut a body exactly in the half, vertically or longitudinally, you get two equal halves, isn't it? So let me draw a picture of roundworm here. Okay, see. So this is a roundworm, and actually this is a female roundworm, and you know, you also have a male roundworm. This is a male roundworm. Okay, what are this? Roundworms. They are also called with the name Ascaris. Okay, scientific name is Ascaris. Roundworms. Female one, male one. And if you cut this exactly into half in a vertical direction, definitely the left side portion looks similar to the right side portion, isn't it? So that's what we call the body is bilaterally symmetrical. Okay, and here also you will observe triploblastic condition. Triploblastic, that means they also have three germ layers. And the third and important point here is they have pseudocoelom. What do you mean by pseudocoelom? Small body cavity, like, you know, an empty space you will find it within a body, right? Pseudocoelom. Say for example, this is a roundworm. If I cut like this, when I see I'm cutting like this. So when I see this, this is a round part. Inside, I see a small cavity. Okay, so when you cut it like this, and when you look at inside part, you know, you will find a small empty space. That is what we call pseudocoelom, right? And they are cylindrical. They are not flat. In Platyhelminthes, you know, the organisms were flat and they were not having any cavity. Remember guys, Platyhelminthes phylum organisms do not have any cavity. But here the organism has a cavity, and the cavity is called pseudocoelom. And they are cylindrical. They are not flat. They are cylindrical. Okay, round shape. Fine. So these are some important points to be remembered. And few more points are there. And you know, they have a complete elementary canal. So what is the point here? Have a complete elementary canal. What do you mean by elementary canal? Say the digestive system. Elementary canal in the sense, you know, the digestive system. So you have a level of organs right from mouth to anus. Okay, so this elementary canal, that means organ system you will observe in these organisms. Okay, so what you are observing? Organ system formation is observed. So what do you mean by organ system formation? So we all very well know that when so many cells combine, you get tissues. When many tissues combine, you get organs. Okay. When many organs are performing one particular function, then we call it as an organ system. Okay. Say for example, whenever an organism takes a food, it has to undergo digestion. So digestion starts from a mouth, right? So in the digestive tract, can you able to figure out what organs are present? Mouth, Then food goes to food pipe, that is esophagus. From esophagus, it will go to the stomach, stomach to intestine. There the nutrients are absorbed. Then the waste material will come out from anus. So mouth to anus, there are so many organs. All of them are involved in doing one particular work. What is that? Digestion. So from mouth to anus, whatever organs are there, you know, that is called alimentary canal. Right? So such alimentary canal, complete alimentary canal, you will observe in the organisms that come under nematoda. So this is a new feature, advanced feature that you are observing in this particular phylum. And this feature was not there in the previous phylums, right? In case of Porifera, Coelenterata, Platyhelminthes, you don't have this organ system formation. Right, like many organs are connected and they do a single work. You know, this is what we call organ systems. Right, so organ system formation takes place from this phylum onwards. Right, remember this point. And now the last and final point is most of these organisms are parasitic. Okay, parasitic in the sense what? Live in other organisms for food. Isn't it? So, say for example, roundworms. You know, they are present in stomach or intestine, right? So usually the organisms which are parasitic always causes diseases. Okay, the organisms which are parasitic, you know, they cause diseases in humans. Say for example, roundworms can present in stomach or intestine can cause digestive problems. Right? Roundworms cause digestive problems in humans. Digestive problems. Okay? Say similarly, you have a worm called filarial worm. Filarial worm. You know, this particular worm causes elephantiasis. Okay, so what do you mean by elephantiasis? Swollen leg. You might have observed in some people that their legs are highly swollen. The legs look like an elephant leg, right? Say that is because of the worm present there, right? So what is the worm? Filarial worm. This is responsible for creating a disease, for causing a disease called elephantiasis. So like this, the worms which are parasitic in nature always causes diseases in humans, right? So this is all about a phylum Nematoda. Now let us watch a beautiful visual on Nematoda.
Nematoda, you can observe the round worms, see the structure is thread-like structures and they are cylindrical, isn't it? And bilaterally symmetric. And this is another type of a worm, filarial worm we call. Scientific name is Uscheria. And this is responsible for elephantiasis. Elephantiasis is a disease where the leg will swell like elephant's leg. So this roundworm family, you know, this particular organism is responsible for causing this disease called elephantiasis. Clear? And different types of roundworms you can observe here, and this is Ascaris roundworm. This is another nematodal worm. This is another type of a worm. And one major point that you have to remember here is sexual dimorphism is seen here. So what do you mean by a sexual dimorphism? Male and female bodies are different. They look different. See, this is a female one. Female one is quite bigger longer than the male one. See, this is a male one. Male one structure is entirely different, isn't it? Say it is having a round loop here, whereas in female is a straight one, round and fatter one, isn't it? So female body is different from male body. So this is a variety of round worm actually, and this particular concept is called as sexual dimorphism. You can note down this point also in your book, which I did not mention on a board. Mention a point that sexual dimorphism, that means male and female bodies look entirely different. Clear? So these are male and female bodies of Ascaris, that means the roundworms. So this is a very important point one must remember, and this elephantiasis point is important. So which worm causes elephantiasis? Filarial worm causes elephantiasis, yes or no? So that's all about roundworms.
Coming to the next phylum, phylum Annelida. Have you ever heard of earthworms? You might have seen earthworms in the agricultural fields, yes or no? So usually earthworms are called as farmer's friends. They are called farmer's friends. Can you tell me why they are called farmer's friends? Because earthworms are very, very important for the farmers, right? Very, very important for the agriculture. Earthworms improve the fertility of soil, and they will loosen the soil. Okay, say if a farmer has to sow a particular seeds, you know, soil has to be loose enough to absorb water, right? Loose enough to dig, you know. Earthworms will help in the loosening of soil. Okay, and they also help in improving the fertility of a soil. And various other uses are there out of earthworms. They are so much important in the field of agriculture. That's the reason earthworms are called farmer's friends. So such beautiful earthworms will come under a phylum called Annelida. And there are 1,000 varieties of organisms under Annelida. Okay, so let us talk about few important characteristics of the phylum Annelida. Say, first and foremost, these organisms have soft body, soft, elongated, that means very long body they have, elongated, okay, and cylindrical. Body is cylindrical, it is not flat, body is cylindrical, okay. So they have soft, elongated and cylindrical body, worm-like, okay. So the body is also worm-like, thread-like, clear, fine. And the next and important point is, even these organisms are bilaterally symmetrical. That means if you cut an organism vertically, you know, you will get two equal left and right parts, okay. And later, even these guys are triploblastic. So what do you mean by triploblastic? Have three germ layers, ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm, right? And here, main important point, this point is very important, and this is what the difference you will observe between the phylum Nematoda and Annelida. Okay. See, the point is, the body is segmented. Body is segmented. What do you mean by the body is segmented? You know, if I have to draw the structure of earthworm, say something like this, okay, and you know, the body looks like this, you will have segment separations, okay. Externally it is observed as rings. You will, when you see with your eyes, you know, you will have these separations, you will have this ring like things on a body. This is what we call segmented. Okay, so the body is segmented, divided into small, small portions. And when externally, when you see with your eyes, you know, they look like a ring. You know, this is what we call earthworm. Okay, and somewhere in the middle, some portion is not segmented, guys. Okay, here some portion is not segmented. And this is the portion where, you know, genitals are present. Like this is the portion that decides whether it is a male or female. You know, reproductive organs are present in this particular portion. And if it is a female one, no, you will have a small pores. We call these pores as genital papillae. We call them as genital papillae. You know, pores in the sense small holes. Through these particular pores, the sperm enters. Sperm from a male organism enters to a female body. If it is a female body, you will have these holes. Okay, fine. So, this is what the structure of earthworm. This is what we call earthworm. Okay, so this is how the body is segmented. Like so many fractions are present. You see that many pieces have joined together. You feel like that actually. You will feel that many pieces have joined with one another. So a long body has formed. That is what we call the body is segmented. Okay, so externally they are visible in the form of rings. Yes or no? In the form of rings. Okay, so you will observe so many ring like things all over the body. They are actually called as segments. Fine. And here organ system formation is observed. So in the previous case also you have seen this point, isn't it? In the family nematoda also, organ system, like you have observed the complete alimentary system from mouth to anus. See, here you will observe along with the alimentary system, you would observe the circulatory system, okay, and the nervous system, right? So these are the organ systems are available, are formed in the species that come under this particular phylum. Clear? So these are the main important points of the organisms of the phylum Annelida. So you have most of the points similar with nematoda, except this point is very important. Here the body is completely segmented, and you know the organ systems are much more developed. It is advanced than the organisms that are there in the phylum Nematoda. Okay, so you know which are the other examples you will observe in the phylum is leeches. Have you heard of leeches? So where are these leeches are present? Moist area. You know, they suck our blood, isn't it? So where are normally these organisms are present? They can be found. They can be found in water or land or soil. Okay, they are present everywhere. They can be present on a land or they can be present in a water also. So these worm like organisms which have a segments and you know much more developed organ system are called annelidans. Okay, so usually the meaning of the word annulum. Okay, this annelida is derived from a Greek word called annulum. You know what do you mean by annulum? Annulum in the sense rings. So when you see with your eyes, you know, you observe an organism having so many rings, right? So that's the reason we call them as annelida. Clear? So that's all about the phylum annelida. So which are the examples here? Earthworms. The best examples are earthworms and leeches. Clear? So with this, I complete this session And let us meet up with some more phylums in the next class. Till then, keep revising the concept. Please like, subscribe our channel to learn the concepts in an easier way and in a detailed way. Thank you so much.